Yes, it's reminding me of that parable that I've told many times. Of my friend Axel, who was guided to go towards the Twin Towers after they had come down. And how he was inspired to walk to Ground Zero.
¿Cómo fue inspirado para ir a caminar al punto cero?
In a miraculous state of mind.
En un estado mental milagroso.
And he got closer and closer.
Y se iba acercando cada vez más.
This was probably less than 2 weeks after the event.
Esto fue probablemente a menos de 2 semanas después de que fue el evento.
And he came upon a Japanese man in a, wearing like a plaid suit. And the Japanese man was, had his head bowed, he was shaking his head and just saying, so sad, so, so sad. And my friend Axel told me, he said, for just this, just an instant, he had the thought pass through his mind. What if my happiness and joy could be an offense to this man? It was just the smallest fleeting thought going through his mind. But as soon as Axel had this thought, he felt the heat, the dust going up his nostrils. He smelled the smells of decaying bodies. Suddenly, the whole situation that was surrounding him took on a reality.
De repente todo lo que estaba a su alrededor se volvió como real.
Just from one thought, I wonder if my joy could be an offense to this man.
Solamente por este pensamiento de creer que si qué tal si mi felicidad es una ofensa para este hombre.
So in A Course in Miracles, Jesus tells us that one of the most difficult ideas to grasp is true empathy. Because if defilement would be possible for one person, it would mean that there is no God. If defilement, like defile, like she felt the knee stuff. Defiled.
Violada, pero que me deje manchada. Manchada.
So it would mean, quería decir que si una persona puede ser manchada, entonces todos pueden ser manchados.
Yeah. That it runs that deep.
Y es así de profundo.
And we could say mistreatment of any degree would mean that there is no God. Because again, God is source and perfect. And everything that is real and true comes from God. And so anything that we think or believe or perceive,
entonces, cualquier cosa que pensamos, o creemos, o percibimos,
that denies the all powerfulness of God,
niega el ser todopoderoso de Dios,
is a temptation.
Es una tentación.
And that's what it was for my friend Axel. It was a tempting thought.
Y eso fue lo que le sucedió a mi amigo Axel. Fue un pensamiento de tentación.
And so we are given circumstances that allow us to to align with the light. And the situation can be involving a family member or a loved one. Just as a very strong opportunity to choose again.
Como una oportunidad muy poderosa para volver a elegir.
I think also when we talk about the death of a loved one,
también creo que al hablar de la muerte de un ser querido,
it reminds me of what Jesus says in A Course in Miracles.
Me recuerda lo que dice Jesús en un curso de milagros.
He says, you have many strange beliefs.
Él dice que tenemos muchas creencias extrañas.
But perhaps the strangest of all your beliefs,
pero quizás la más extraña de todas tus creencias,
is that you can lose the ones that you love.
Es que tú puedes perder a aquellos a quienes amas.
It is so different than heaven.
Y eso es tan diferente del cielo.
Where loss is impossible.
Donde no, es imposible la pérdida.
So different from the idea that there are angels surrounding us.
Tan diferente de la idea de que hay ángeles que nos están rodeando.
Encouraging us to remember to laugh at illusions.
Que nos están alentando a que nos acordemos de reírnos de las ilusiones.
Because once one illusion is taken as serious,
porque una vez que una ilusión se toma en serio,
then all the rest must follow.
Entonces,
must follow.
Entonces, todas las que siguen, todas las demás tendrán que seguir inevitablemente.
Yeah. Just like when they say that the devil is legion. Really, it's just one tiny thought. But if we give the power of our Christ mind to that one tiny thought, we seem to have a legion of illusions that we must face.
Parece ser que tenemos una legión de ilusiones que debemos enfrentar.